I went out the wrong way.
Good afternoon. Today we are going to talk about radiation protection. Radiation protection is very important in radiology department in the hospital. Some questions are why radiology protection, for what we use radiation protection, who to protect, and how to protect. First, we discuss about the radiation units. Radiation units, first Röntgen, do a Röntgen. It is a unit of radiation exposure that will be deliberate charge of 2.5 to 10 to the power of 4 units per kg of air. It is independent of air of fuel cell. Observed dose, deposition of energy in patient by radiation exposure, independent of composition of radiation material and energy of fuel. That is unit of absorption dose. Gray also a SI unit of absorbed dose. Gray defined as quantity of radiation that result in energy deposition 1 joules per kiloton. 1 gray equal to 100 rads, 1 rad is equal to 1 centigrade. Dose equivalent, it is measure of biological effectiveness of radiation. It is unit of absorbed dose of equivalent. It has SI unit, it is called Sieverest. 1 Sieverest equal to 100 rems. Dose equivalent calculated by the absorbed dose into quantification factor. Quality factor, it is a parameter used to describe the quality of wound. Given the amount of energy deposit per unit of length you travel, expressed in kilovolts per micron. For example, in X-ray radiation, Q factor 1, gamma 1 and like alpha particles like pointing. That's all. Effective dose equivalent, its purpose is to relate exposure to risk. It is calculated by the multiplying the dose equivalent and received by the Janicron. Each individual organ or tissue by an appropriate tissue weighting factor and summing of all the tissue involved. Is there radiation in this room? The answer is yes, because background radiation is there in everywhere, in every room or everywhere. Your natural source of radiation is cosmic radiation. Cosmic radiation within our body, in food we eat, water we drink, house we live, building material, etc. It's all there in background radiation. For example, in New Delhi, for example, in Italy, 700 microns per year is background radiation there. Radiation we travel with in traveling flight above the 15 kilometers, radiation is more. In going upwards, more. Radiation in natural and man-made sources. Source of radiation in most of the time it is a natural source, here 82%. Man-made like medical. And the nuclear industry, like 0.1% nuclear reactors. Yeah, source of radiation, natural radiation, it is external and internal. External radiation, like cosmic and gamma radiation. Internal radiation, radionuclide within the body, ingested or inhaled. And second one, medical procedure using the diagnostic and therapeutic. Nuclear weapons, industry, and accidents. Primary type of ionizing radiation has mainly alpha particles, beta particles, gamma rays, and X-rays and neutrons. Yes, we need radiation protection. Here the effects of radiation is burning. And radiation effects is mainly two types is there, deterministic effect, stochastic effect. Here type of effect like cell death or cell transformation are both. Cell death here is a deterministic effect. Cell transformation is stochastic effect. Cell transformation is going to be give cancer blooming cells. Here it comes. Here is a threshold. Threshold is there. If that threshold is reached, here the symptoms must appear. Severity of the effect is increased with dose. A large number of cells are involved. Some cases cataract develop in the eyes. The radiation dose must be 2 to 10 grays. Permanent sterility in males 3.5 to 6 grays. Females 2.5 to 6 grays. Temporary sterility is there some patients. Here stochastic effect, there is a no threshold. Here probability of effect increased with dose. Generally occur with a single cell. Here no, one X-ray also may give cancer after 10 to 12 years. Here no threshold. So like cancer and most genetic effects predisposed. First radiation hit the nucleus and change the nucleus and the DNA mutation, then it going into the cancer cells. In our body, some mechanisms are there to repair DNA damage. However, it is not 100% effective. That leads to cancer. Outcome of all, after all cell exposure, DNA to damage, if damage repair, then cure. If don't repair, cell going to necrosis or apoptosis. If these mechanisms fail, cell going to transform cells like cancer cells. Here the timing of event leading to radiation effects. First, energy deposition like X-rays and on excitation ionization, initial particles drag on radiation formation, diffuse chemical reactions of initial DNA breaks and base damage. Lastly, teratogenesis in cancer and hereditary defect. Here, chain of events following exposure to ionizing radiation. First, we expose, then it ionizes, then free radicals form, like HOCl. Then free radicals damage DNA and RNA and engine. Then subcellular damage like membranes, nucleus and chromosomes and cellular level. Cellular level leads to cell death and in deterministic effect. In stochastic effects, cellular transformation may be some repair. Some cells mostly highly radiosensitive, some low radiosensitive. Highly radiosensitive is more dividing cells, less time in G1S to GT phase like M phase. Here is more time for repair to DNA, then it's go to cell transformation like cancer cells. Here has high radiosensitive like bone marrow cells and spleen, thymus and lymphatic nodes, gonads, IgNs, lymphocytes. And medium risk radiosensitive cells like skin, mesoderm, organs like heart, lung. Low radiosensitive cells, muscles, bones and nervous system. So radiation, radiation we are safe. Even in 1 to 3 millisieverts has no effect, little negligible effect. It can kill 4000 millisieverts. So where some point is there, in radiological department, for example from X-ray or CTR fluoroscopy, so certain radiation exposure there, but has some safe limit point theoretically. So principles of radiation protection, it is a justification of practice, optimization of protection by keeping exposure as low as reasonably achievable, and dose limitation. So justification, so no practice involving exposure to radiation should be adopted unless it provides sufficient benefit of deterministic effect of radiation. Here, if in OP department, doctor advised X-ray, it has some benefits. That's why he advised X-ray. So optimization reduction, protection should be optimized in related to the magnitude of dose, number of people exposure for all socio-economic state of patients. Optimization protection can be achieved by the optimizing procedure to administer the radiation dose which as low as reasonable achievable. So as derived mechanism, diagnostic information with minimal discomfort to the patient. Here is the main, a lot of principles must follow in radiation protection as low as reasonably achieved. Application principles. Here X-ray tube, for example, X-ray tube delivered with X-rays like primary beams. Yeah, I'm here patient. So patient exposure to primary beam. After exposure to patient, this very scattered radiation is, this is scattered radiation mainly affect the surrounding individuals, some patients, technicians. So we must as low as decrease scattered radiation. There is some mechanisms, some technique there to reduce scattered radiation. First, X-ray tube position. This is position of X-ray tube under the patient and not above the patient. Here the first one above the patient, second one is below the patient. The largest amount of scattered radiation is produced where the X-ray beam enters the patient. By positioning the X-ray tube below the patient, you decrease the amount of scattered radiation that reaches your body. Factors affecting the X-ray beam: tube current, tube potential, high or low jet target material and filtration, type of waveform. Tube current, if more current is there, more radiation. This is the X-ray tube, this is the exit window. Here the filter is there that will reduce the radiation exposure. Collimation is one of the important one to decrease radiation exposure. Collimator is tightened to the area of interest, reduce the patient total entrance of skin exposure, it improves the image contrast, scatter radiation to the operator will also decrease. Here the open beam, here collimator beam. Here open beam is more wide radiation, here only concise part, here the less image radiation. Patient protection also very important for correcting the filters. Here the filtration is 0.5 mm, minimum aluminum equivalent filters must be placed in X-ray primary beam areas. Added filter also good, minimum total filtration by inherent and added must be 2.5 mm aluminum equivalents. Here accurate collimation. We also less minimum repeats, don't expose them multiple times. Here amount of type and radiation exposure. Here is the time, distance and speed. It is a triad. Time as much as low, distance as much as long distance, shieldings. Shielding we will discuss later. Time. Exposure time related to the radiation exposure and exposure rate as follows. Exposure time equal to exposure by exposure rate. Exposure rate in time. The algebraic expression simply implies that if the exposure time is kept short, then the resulting dose of the individual is small. Exposure rate is short, then dose of the exposure is very small. Distance. The second radiation protection action related to the distance between the source of radiation and exposure individuals. The exposure to the individual decrease inversely as this square of distance. This is known as the inverse square law. Stated mathematically 1 equal to 1 by b square. Here if distance is two times increase, radiation exposure is 4 times decrease. Then the radiation in radiation X-ray room, they must distance 3 meters distance is must there from X-ray tube to the technician operating system. In mobile X-rays, at least 2 meters must be distance maintained between the X-ray tube and the operator. Shielding. Shielding applies the certain materials like concrete lead will attenuate radiation, then reduce its intensity when they are placed between the source of radiation and the exposure at individuals. Lead is used radiation shielding material and it has high atomic number. Atomic number of elements is the number of protons in the nucleus, which is equal to the number of electrons around the nucleus. For the photoelectric process, the mass absorption coefficient increases with the cube of atomic number. It is more that, for example, to 0.25 mm lead thickness attenuated 66% of the beam at 75 kV. If then increase 1 mm, the attenuation 99%. So, the recommendation that the general purpose radiography, the minimum thickness of lead equivalent is protective apparel should be 0.5 mm. Shielding is multiple X-ray TV, boom shielding, personal shielding and patient shielding. X-ray tube shielding, in X-ray tube, the inner is coated with lead, then outer is coated with steel material, which prevents the scatter radiation from inside the X-ray tube. Room shielding is two types, primary shielding, secondary shielding. The lead line wall of radiology department are referred as a protective barrier because they are designed to protect individuals located outside the X-ray room from the unwanted radiation. There are two types of protective barriers, primary barriers, one which directly struck the primary or the visible beam, secondary barrier, one which exposes secondary radiation either by leakage from X-ray tube by scatter radiation from the patient. ARB has laid down guidelines for shielding at X-ray examination room and patient waiting area, which as follows. The room housing of X-ray lead not less than 18 meters square for general purpose radiography and conventional fluoroscopic equipment. In case of installation located in the residential complex, it ensures that wall of the X-ray on which the primary X-ray beam form not less than 35 centimeters thick brick are equal. Walls of X-ray room on which scatter X-ray fall is not less than 23 centimeters thick brick are equal. There is a shielding equivalent to at least 23 centimeters thick brick or 1.7 mm lead in front of the doors and windows of the X-ray room to protect the adjacent area used by the general public. There is a normally wall thickness, like if exposure is direct to the wall, it must be 35 centimeters. If you prevent the scatter radiation, the side walls like it must be 23 centimeters thick or equal, like this. Unshielded opening in X-ray room for a ventilator and natural lights are located above the height of 2 meters. Room housing fluoroscopy equipment are so designed to adequate darkness can be achieved conventionally and designed in the room. Shielding of the X-ray control room. Shielding of the X-ray control room must be important because technician exposed multiple times on daily basis. The control room of X-ray equipment is a secondary protective barrier which has two important aspects. The walls of viewing room of the control room, which should be lead equivalent to 1.5 mm. The location of control room, which should not be located in the primary beam fall directly. And radiation should be scattered twice before the entering room. That's why the control room must be there in corner, so that scatter radiation will not directly place technician. Next important, patient waiting area. Patient waiting area is provided by the outside X-ray room. A suitable warning signal such as red light and warning face is provided as a conspicuous place outside the X-ray room, kept on when the unit is in. Use a warn person not to connect with the particular examination for entering room. Lead aprons is personal protection equipment. Here, shielding apron recommended for use of radiation workers. These are classified as secondary barriers to the effect of ionization radiation. Care of lead aprons is very important. Lead aprons not abused, such as dropping them on the floor, killing them in the heat, improving the dynamic of the back of the chair, because all these actions can cause internal fracture of the lead. They may compromise the apron protective ability. When it is not used, all protective apparatus should be hanged on properly designed racks. Protective apparatus also should be radioed off for a defect such as internal crack at least once a year. If there is crack in this lead apparatus, there is no use of this because excess are exposed. Other protective apparatus include eyeglasses with side shields, thyroid shields and hand gloves. The minimum protective lead equipment in hand gloves and thyroid shields should be 0.5 mm. In patient shielding, most area of the department shields the workers and attendants playing little and insulin to the radiation protection to patient. But patient shielding also important because in pregnant women, suppose exposure to the hand like that, they must expose, they must protect the ovaries. Ovary has more sensitive for radiation. It is recommended that thyroid, breast and gonads should be shielded to protect these organs, especially in children and young adults. Here are some warning signs like door sense, caution, X-ray radiation. If X-ray is going on, X-ray room, which must outside place X-ray is on. So warning signs. It has been estimated on the CT amount for CT is more exposure, as we all know. Less than 50% of all the X-ray examination is contributed to be up to be 40% of collected dose from the diagnostic area. CT scanner has scattered radiation levels that may prove hazardous. The dose unit of CT is the computer tomography dose index. So here, protection of pregnant women. There is a great risk of fetus of chromosomal abnormality and subsequent mental radiation between 8 to 15 weeks of pregnancy, and the examination involving radiation to the fetus should be avoided during this period. For examination, which may involve rather heavy dose of radiation such as durum minimum, pelvis or abdominal CT, the examination should be carried out during the first 10 days of menstrual cycle to avoid irradiation of any possible pregnancy. This is called first 10 days rule. 10 days rule must follow the any pregnant women or any possible pregnancy women. If the pelvic area is in green area, no possible pregnancy, next procedure X-ray. Probably pregnant, then radiologists decide delay the X-ray until after the delivery or use non-X-ray techniques like ultrasounds. Go ahead with X-ray, but keep dose low, with low dose. High dose procedures like as you already know, X-ray first 10 days of menstrual cycle. Pregnancy and mammography. Here is some article is there. There is no requirement to inquire about the pregnancy prior to the mammography, as there is no significant dose for the patient. Mammography usually is a very, very low dose used. That means negligible effect for pregnant women. For pregnancy staff, risk assessment must be performed. Dose of fetus less than millisievert for rest of the pregnancy. Radiation detection and measurements. The instruments used to detect radiation and refer to as the radiation detection devices. Instruments used to measure radiation are called radiation dosimeters. Dosimeters is a device to monitor record the imaging radiation, like in occupation exposure, must distinguish from the background radiation. That's why dosimeters never carry the room or outside. We must place in department, then use it to while exposure to radiation. Here is an example of pocket dosimeter. It looks like pen. It consists of thimble ionizing chamber with eyepiece and transparent scales, a hollow charging rod, and fixed and movable fibers, electrometer, separate and built in self-feeding type. Here, the ability of radiation to produce ionization in air is the basis for radiation detection from ionizing chamber. It consists of electrodes positioned in the middle of the cylinder that contain gas. When X-ray into the chamber, they ionize the gas from negative ions and positive ions. Secondly, one of the personal that in that is here the plastic fiber is there and the open window and metal filters. It detects the gamma X-rays. Wearing the badge and the collar region, because the collar region includes head, neck and lens of the eye are unprotected. Very clear, each member of staff wearing a film badge for a period of 4 weeks. At the end of the year, the film inside the change, the exposure film is sent to the bar of communication. Useful to detect radiation at or above the 0.1 millisievers. It has advantage like inexpensive, easy to use, permanent record of exposure, wide range of sensitivity, identify types energy exposure. Another one, thermoluminescent dosimeter. The limitation of the film badge is overcome in the region. Thermoluminescent dosimeter. Thermoluminescent dosimeter with property of certain material to limit light when they are stimulated by the heat. Materials such as lithium chloride, lithium borate, calcium chloride, and calcium sulfate have been used to make thermoluminescent dosimeters. When lithium chloride crystals are exposed to radiation, a few electrons become trapped in the high energy level. For these electrons to return their normal energy levels, the lithium chloride crystals must be heated. As the electron return to the stable state, light is emitted because of the energy difference between the two orbital levels. The amount of light emitted is measured by the photoelectric tube and is proportional to the radiation. The measurement of radiation from thermoluminescent dosimeter is two-step process. Step 1 is first TLD that will be exposed to radiation. Here, step 2, lithium chloride crystals is placed in a TLD analyzer where it is exposed to the heat. As the crystal is exposed to the increasing temperature, light is emitted. When the intensity of light is plotted as a function of the temperature, a glow curve is observed. A glow curve can be used to find out how much radiation energy is received by the crystal, because the highest peak and the area under the curve are proportional to the energy radiation. Here is the look like the TLD badge. TLD badge advantages: can measure the exposure to individual as well as some individuals, can withstand certain degree of heat, humidity and pressure. The crystals are reusable, it is very compact, suitable even for film like dosimeter. Instantaneous reading or positive if the department has TLD analyzer. Response radiation proportional to the up to 400 radius. Disadvantage is very expensive, no permanent recall. Cannot be distributed, radioactive contamination. The great disadvantage is TLD badge cost. So regulatory bodies there must to regulate the radiation using X-rays or some nuclear energy. Various regulatory bodies that are international and national which lay down the norms of radiation protection. These are International Commission of Radiation Protection, ICRP, the National Commission for Radiation Protection in America, and the Atomic Energy Regulatory Body in India. The Indian regulatory body, Atomic Energy Regulatory Body, was constituted in 1983. The state of India will exercise powers of Section 27 of the Atomic Energy Act. It carries out certain regulatory and safety functions under the Act. According to the AERB, here we have some dose limiting recommendations. Whole body effective dose, occupation workers, 20 millisieverts per year. Average over a defined period of 5 years with no more than 50 millisieverts in single years. In public, only 1 millisieverts in a year, average over 5 years. Whole body, here part of the body, equivalent dose, length of the eye, here 150 millisieverts, skin 500, eye and feet 500 millisieverts. Occupational exposure, compared to public, more exposure to the radiation. Here is the diagram. Hospital administration must have radiation safety committee and radiation safety officer. Radiation safety both have major activities, guidelines and recommendation, radiation protection survey, quality assurance, monitoring and record keeping, education and training, other activities. Last conclusion, protect patient, public and staff remember dose in the stimulative in stochastic effect. If multiple times it is repeated, the dose also improves. By ordering the X-ray or CT, most calculated benefit and skin risk ratio. Principles of radiation protection must remember. Dose reduction by decreasing the time exposure, distance, step away from the primary exposure beam, shielding, light course stops cathode radiation. Then it leads to the radiation, decreased radiation to exposure. Thank you.